We've been talking a lot about Iowa, but Nevada's caucuses are also coming up. Those are scheduled for Saturday, February 22nd. Nevada will be the third state to weigh in on the party's nominee after Iowa and New Hampshire. This year, voters can make their preferences known even sooner. For the first time, Democrats there can vote early for their top candidate. For more, let's bring in Steve Sebelius. He's the politics and government editor for the Las Vegas Journal Review. Steve, thanks so much for being with us.
Glad to be with you, Elaine. Thanks for having me.
So you reported the Democratic Party has rolled out new transparency efforts ahead of the state's caucus this year. Besides early voting, can you walk us through why this cycle will be different?
Yeah, there was actually initially a proposal to have phone-in voting. But the DNC, which had encouraged local and state parties to find ways to get more people involved, nixed that idea because of security. So we're stuck with the early voting, 4 days of that. You go and mark a preference card, and then that is counted on the caucus day, which, as you mentioned, is February 22nd. Some other differences, there's more candidates than Nevada has ever seen since it moved up to the early place on the calendar in 2008. We've got 11 candidates that are still left on that ballot. So it's going to be a very crowded ballot, and I think there's a lot for people to take in.
Well, early voting begins February 15th. That's in about 3 weeks. How are we seeing candidates ramp up their efforts in the state before people make their final choice?
Well, I tell you, I think some of them may have actually got apartments here. They're here so often. They're coming to the Culinary Union. The Culinary Union has had town halls with featuring every major candidate. So union members who are going to make up a very big part of the electorate, there are several strip caucus locations inside casinos. They have heard from every single candidate. The East Las Vegas Community Center, which is in a largely Hispanic area just east of downtown Las Vegas, has become politics central. I think every major candidate has been there as well, some multiple times. So the candidates are all over Nevada. Whenever they can squeeze a spare minute in, they're definitely here.
Realistically, Steve, is there enough time for these candidates to change any minds?
Oh, I absolutely. I think there is. Polls are showing that there's a large a segment of people who have yet to make up their mind. I think they're still hearing from everybody. Tom Steyer, who started late but spent big, has rocketed up in Nevada and elsewhere because he is literally in every place. He's on billboards on the freeway. He's in your mailbox. He's on your television. You can't turn on the television for more than 5 minutes without seeing a Steyer ad. So, yeah, I think it's definitely possible for candidates to change people's minds.
Well, as you noted in your piece, to paraphrase, Nevada really likes winners and really dislikes losers. So how might results from Iowa and New Hampshire affect the outcome in Nevada?
Well, that's absolutely true. Nevada abhors a loser, and if they perceive a candidate not doing as well as they thought they might do in those two early states, that might turn some people against them. It looks like it's a contest between Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders. Sanders is leading in Iowa, New Hampshire. So if he wins those two states, is this likely? Because Iowa and New Hampshire have never really been kind to Joe Biden. Joe Biden's going to look at Nevada as a backstop, and he's doing well here. He's several points ahead of Bernie Sanders in the polls. So if that holds, this could be his comeback.
Well, President Trump lost Nevada by only about 2 percentage points in 2016. It's considered a battleground state this year. How much do you expect the president to play a part in whether people participate this year?
Well, I think that the president is definitely driving turnout among Democrats, because that's one thing I've heard time and again is, in fact, one person put it, look, I don't care who the nominee is. We just have to stop President Trump from getting reelected. So I think he's going to drive turnout. But the president himself, as you know, he is not going to let Iowa go without doing a caucus day events for himself here. Mm-hmm. He is the Nevada Republican Party has foregone a caucus, but they're going to have a vote to bind their delegates to President Trump on the very day of the Democratic caucus. So he's not letting anything go. And I think Nevada is definitely part of his alternative math to get to 270 in this cycle, although it wasn't in last cycle. And it's going to be a fairly close race, I think.
I think you're right. Steve Sebelius. Steve, thank you so much for your time.
Absolutely, Elaine. Thanks for having me.